Every time you've seen them before you started working here, they were sitting there, looking professional all the time.
Some news is very crazy.
And they're trying to keep cool out there if you can. Of course, you can see a 7-day forecast on page 2 of the daily reflect.
Yeah, it's time to drink lots of water.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thanks, Ben. Well, as Ben said a little while ago, today is the 21st of June, which is the first day of summer.
What my job is I'm a producer, and I just come in and basically put the rundown together, which is the show, and stack it. Claudine does it on weekends most of the time, but during the week I'll just stack the show for the anchors, assign what they're supposed to read or write, and just take down news, write as much as I can. I have to edit a lot of stuff to help get the newscast on.
Hey, Claude, something's going on with the, oh, here's the bus accident. We can put that in there. It's got the accident scene and everything.
Which accident?
That bus accident, the Greyhound press conference.
Oh, yeah, the follow-up or whatever?
Yeah, but it's also got pictures of the scene, too.
Let's see that.
Put both in there.
That sounds good.
It's on the 20. I already have it in there anyway.
Yeah, that's good. After the train derailment.
Yeah. I time the show once we go on air, give time cues for sports, weather, things like that.
This is Nathan.
I just kind of run everything and try to keep everything in order and organized. The director and I work very close together because if I change something in the rundown, he's got to know so that it doesn't air odd or that, there's a last minute change and he doesn't know about it, we go on air, it's a mess up. So I work very close with the director. And I guess I'm in charge of everything, but it's kind of teamwork. We all work together to put on the best cast that we can.
Now your forecast from Story Team 9.
My job is to control all the on-air stuff, like the video, the sound, and make sure I supervise everybody else, make sure they're getting on everything over the air right, the camera shots, loading the video, choosing where it's from, doing the wipes, supering the names in, and pretty much just making sure everybody else does their job right.
It's like a machine almost. You're only as good as your weakest link, and little tiny mistakes can make it crazy.
We go out at 28:30. We have 25 seconds. Oh, damn, I'm losing my mind.
I thought it'd be totally different than it is.
15 seconds.
Slow zoom out one.
U.S. Iran tomorrow.
Music.
World Cup.
Slow zoom out.
Sorry. Well, that's all the time we have.
Pass out, boy.
And we're out.
Oh, my God, I'm sorry. That was all screwed up.
I was very intimidated when I started doing this because there's so much to do and so much to learn, and I felt like I wasn't good enough or that I didn't have the experience needed to do this because it is on television and tons of people see it, and if I mess up or somebody else messes up, then other people can see it. And I was scared that I wouldn't live up to what everyone here at the station expected out of a producer because I've never done it before.
That's what I did. I timed it at like 33:30 for some reason. I'm going, oh, we got, oh, much more time. Okay,
you said
20?
Yeah, the audio operator, you have your cameras, and everything has to be in sync, almost like a ballet or a play. Everything has to hit at a certain specific time. If nobody's at their certain mark at the right moment, then it can just throw everything off.
From the south and southwest, and that will be the rule for the next several days. So again, keep that air conditioner running. As highs will be well into the 90s. Lows only in the 70s across the
board. And then you got to get the keys right, the over-the-shoulder shots. Front operator with his supers, he has to be right on the mark, and audio operator. So everybody has to just work in sync and be pretty much one almost to pull it off. It rarely happens that way, but when it does, it feels good. It's like running a marathon. If you win, it feels real good.
I love what I do. I love the TV business. I think it's fun. It's exciting. When everything's going wrong, to me, is like when it's the most fun. I don't even know how to explain that. It sounds crazy, but when everybody's energized and everything's going nuts and we don't know where stuff is and we got spot news, you know, that's to me when it's the, that's when it's fun, because after a while it all is pretty routine.
Brian, what did he say was dead?
So working as a team, everything that is done has an effect on what happens during the show. I mean, one person can throw a whole show into a real bad loop.
Like earlier tonight, I had net up too long, network when we came out, and when it went to bars, tone went over air. For everybody in the world to hear, and that was my fault because I didn't take network out. So,
once I got in the swing of things, it started becoming natural. And I still mess up, but I don't think I'm that bad. I try not to be anyway.
Well, we'll have to wait and see. Maine Stewart looking good for most of the way, led for the first and second round. We have highlights of round three from San Francisco, plus the rest of the day in sports. Round three, Major League Baseball, World Cup, and more. Sports is coming back.
I'm glad I do what I do on this side. I'm glad I don't have to go work with the people, because a lot of people have a negative aspect of news and try and avoid news. But on the other hand, you have the people who really do like news and don't feel they're a problem or get in the way or anything like that.
I have a lot of people ask me a lot of questions about the people that are on camera. What they're like.
I'm sorry.
If they're rude, if they're mean, if they're nice, if they're sweet. But I really personally don't have to deal with it because a lot of people on the average won't even know I worked here.
And you always tell the truth, right?
Yes, always. How nice everyone is.
No, like for instance, before I started working at the TV station, this is the first television station I've worked at. You know, if you grow up in the area or you live in the area for a long period of time, you see these people on television every day, but you don't see them like around town. So when you first come in, you're kind of like, wow, you see these people sitting here talking to all the people that are on TV.
10 years from now, Camille would like to be working network maybe. I'd like to produce a show, maybe like Dateline or something like that. I don't think I want to be in local news forever. I want to do something big, something more. So hopefully in 10 years from now, I'll be network or producing maybe a talk show or something like that. And something, I guess, along the little trashy side maybe. Well, soap opera type talk show or something. I don't know. But I think that would be what I want to do 10 years from now.
Brief but intimate portrait of television news, there are some things that we can learn from these people. If it isn't their quiet courage, maybe it's their joyful euphemism that we admire so much. Whatever the case, one thing remains clear, that we all, as in life, depend on and need one another. And maybe, just maybe, that's the true lesson to be learned here.